Alberto Berkowski, so that even the people outside can hear me. So, for Alberto Berkowski from IMATE Cuernavaca, now. He's going to talk about foliations by hyperbolic surfaces on three manifolds. Thank you, Alberto.
Well, thank you very much for this opportunity to speak here. So I think it's the third conference of this type that I come center. It's always done in a beautiful place, so it's very nice. What I'm going to speak is very geometric, very constructive, and the title says it's a foliation of hyperbolic surfaces on three manifolds. And so, I mean, William Thorston is a hero of my generation. He passed away 4 years ago, in 2012, and he actually started from the work of George Rey in 1952. He found a foliation of the sphere, famous F foliation, no real F foliation. And it has been shown that foliations play an essential role in the study of three-dimensional manifolds, as for instance, the work of Carigali, Fermi, and Gabay. And foliations by surfaces have a beautiful property that is an observation by Elmar Winkel-Kemper and also Rebis. Suppose you have a manifold of dimension 3 foliated by surfaces, compact. Take a point and take a leaf that, and well, you can choose an ambient metric and use the metric on the surface of one of the leaves of the foliation, and the surface knows its type. In other words, the uniformization theorem of Poincaré tells you that the metric is conformally equivalent to one and only one metric of constant curvature, minus one, or zero. The case of curvature one means that what the leaf is a sphere, and all foliations will be orientable, is a sphere, and that implied by a famous theorem of Rey that every leaf is a sphere. And therefore that case we won't consider. And therefore there were only a dichotomy, either a leaf is the metric is conforming equivalent to a flat metric or to a hyperbolic metric. And no matter what metric ambient you give, the metric knows, I am hyperbolic, I am, every leaf knows. So it makes perfect sense to speak of a foliation by hyperbolic surfaces. It's an intrinsic property only of the manifold and the foliation. And so the purpose of my talk is to try to describe a methods to construct such foliations. But I want a little bit more. I want the foliation to be minimal. Minimal means that every leaf is dense. And so these are the two qualities that I want for my foliation. And this is, well, you know, like surfaces of general types, like the most generic surface, also hyperbolic surfaces, like the most, almost all of them. Riemann surfaces of flat metric are only compact, it's only the torus. And the other ones are all sorts of every genus greater than one. And that's what I want. So actually, if you have a foliation with all leaves hyperbolic, which I told you makes sense, every leaf, therefore, has a uniformization map. There's a map unique up to precomposition with a Möbius transformation from the disk with the Poincaré metric, Lobachevsky Poincaré metric into the leaf that uniformizes the leaf. And a theorem that I proved a long time ago and then was also proven in the case of laminations by Alberto Candel, so simultaneous, was that you have a simultaneous uniformization of the leaves that varies continuously. Recently, I think I can prove that actually is differential, but that's it's still not completely. And actually, a recent paper I received this in preparation says that the Yamabe, the Berger theorem is valid. Namely, you prescribe a function's infinity function, satisfying sort of a Gauss Bonnier type of condition, implies there is a metric in the ambient such that the curvature along the leaves exactly precisely that function gave you. And therefore, makes the uniformization theorem sort of useless, but not quite. Well, that's the introduction. Well, they appear naturally in the story of complex ideal dynamics, and is fantastic because you can do many dynamical things like the work of Javier Gómez-Mont. You have a foliation by hyperbolic surfaces, then you have leaf by leaf, leaf-wise geodesic flow in the unitangent bundle of the leaves, which is another bundle, another foliation. You have the horocyclic flow, and you have questions of minimality, ergodicity, the Lyapunov of exponents, is connected with number theory, with an infinite number of things, so it's very, very good. And actually, this ADDM are my co-authors, Fernando Alcalde, Françoise Talbot, Mathilde Martinez, and myself, prove that if you have a minimal foliation, every distance, and all of I hyperbolic, then it's a dichotomy. Either all of them are of finite type, or all are of infinite type. Finite type means the fundamental group is finitely generated. So therefore, being not of infinite type means essentially the surface and the composes as infinite union of pans plus cylinders, very complicated structure. And well, the natural question is which manifolds have been minimal foliations by hyperbolic surfaces, of which types? And well, there are many theorems from the 60s. In the 60s, there was a boom in the foliation theory, and then this really increased with the work of Thorsten, fantastic job. And there are obstructions, for instance, the following. There's a famous Novikov theorem that says that if one single leaf does not inject the fundamental group, a non-simply connected gene, then, in fact, it has a red component. The red component is the famous torus foliated, as you know, by its classical red foliation. And therefore, a foliation like that automatically has a flat leaf. It has a leaf, the torus, no matter what nature you give, will always be conformally equivalent to the flat torus. And therefore, that's already an obstruction. In the sphere, you cannot put hyperbolic. And then, well, Bill Thorsten did his thesis at Berkeley under the direction of Maurice Hirsch, and influenced a lot by Blaine Lawson and Massey. And he put the following beautiful theorem. Suppose you have a surface and you have a circle bundle. In fact, it's valid for cipher vibrations. You have a circle bundle. And you have a foliation with a red component. Namely, that type of foliations are called dot foliations. I will explain later. And it's a beautiful thesis theorem of Thorsten that I never published. It's a beautiful piece. In that case, you can isotope a foliation in order to render it transverse to the circles. Corollary, the foliation is essentially given by a representation of the fundamental group into the group of diffeomorphisms of the circle, namely it's a flat bundle. Flat in the sense of group, not of PSL2R, but some. And that's a fantastic theorem. And that will apply in particular that is an obstruction to social manifolds. Another beautiful theorem says that if you have a dot foliation, namely every leaf injected fundamental group, there's another definition, but without red components, then since every leaf injects fundamental group, the universal cover, every leaf unwraps to be planes, and therefore you have a manifold foliated by planes. Now there's a beautiful theorem of Palmeira, a fantastic theorem says, if you have a simply connected manifold foliated by planes, then it has Rn. Beautiful. And the foliation is very easy to describe. Foliation is actually of the following form. I put as an exercise to the young people, tell me all the foliations, non-singular foliations of the plane, one-dimensional foliations, then foliation by curves of the plane. And it's easy to see that each leaf has to be closed as a subset. Because if it wraps around, it has a closed transversal, and if you have a closed transversal, Poincaré-Hopf theorem tells you there's singularity, and I'm not allowing singularities. And therefore, foliations by curves, by lines on the plane, are very, very beautiful. They are foliated by close embedded copies of the real line, but it's not, the parallel lines is not the only one. Imagine the following situation. You have parallel lines from here to here. parallelized from here to here. This is supposed to be the plane. And here you put hyperboloids, what is a refoliation, and then one beautiful by Heflinger, actually the thesis of Heflinger and Reb, show that the foliations of the plane are in one-to-one correspondence with non-Hausdorff simply connected manifolds, because the leaf space is always a manifold, but maybe not separated. And that's the first use I was really happy to know that the non-Hausdorff manifolds are useful in real estate, therefore that's in one. And actually, this one I was giving you like that, this example, corresponds to 10 to cups of a real line, and glue the two negative half spaces, you glue them together, and then the origin of one is not glued to the other one, and you have clearly a manifold. That's the first example. But there's one, it's called la plume composée, la pluma compuesta, is one that is non-Hausdorff everywhere. And that can happen. Well, coming back to Palmeira showed, therefore, that any manifold of dimension, arbitrary dimension, which is simply connected, affiliated by hyperplanes of codimension 1, diffeomorphic to Rn minus 1, actually the ambiguous space is Rn, and the affiliation is given by affiliation of the plane, the y described, cross Rn minus 2, complete classification. And therefore, okay, so here, I spoke a lot about foliation. I didn't even give you the foliation. So the definition of foliation in the case I'm interested is simply a partition of the three manifold, partition in the set theoretical sense, such that there exist open sets, covered by open sets, so that if you take the partition of that open set, it looks like the inverse image of projection in your life, foliated by tortillas, you know, or crepe. For Carlos Cinso, PEP, or you go Las Vegas. Okay, so that's the way it looks. That's the definition. I mean, forget about Elgin, blah, 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 blah. It looks exactly locally like a product of a disk cross an interval. That's what it is. And they are glued together in a very well, foliated chart, definition. Well, the only observation is that these gluing maps, I could have them to be holomorphic, to be. It makes sense to speak of three-dimensional manifold foliated by Riemann surfaces. Mm-hmm. Namely, along the leaves, there's a complex structure. Okay, so this is the definition of what I was saying, taut foliation. A codimension one foliation of three manifold is said to be taut if it admits a complete cross transversal. In other words, there's a bending of the circle, which is transverse to F, and whose image intersects all leaves. No? A foliation having a red component, not a red component, you enter the torus and you are trapped forever. And therefore, it's not taut. And that fundamental property of that is that every leaf injects this fundamental group, and therefore the universal coverings are free, and therefore the pi 1 is torsion free, and it's infinite. Mm-hmm. And therefore, it's a very strong topological restriction. To be foliated, therefore, on the title of my talk, if you have a three-dimensional manifold foliated by hyperbolic surfaces, automatically the universal covering is R3. But maybe H3, the hyperbolic, which is diffeomorphic to R3. And the foliation may be not probably very complicated, and so that's what For instance, here's an example. There are manifolds that do not have taut foliation. For instance, S2 crosses 1. No matter what you do, essentially the only foliation is that one, S2 crosses 1 by fiber, and modifications by Reb surgery. So once you have a foliation, you do the following trick. You take a curve, a transverse circle, and then you take a tubular neighborhood, and that's foliated by disks. Remove the disks and glue using some turbularization, it's called. So you can add red components, and sometimes you can suppress them. But and in this case, I'm talking only of taut foliations. And here is what I told you, according to a very deep theory by Palmeira. I remember, this is just small, very quickly. I remember when Palmeira proved that, I was in Brazil with Ennis Oliver, and he is a fantastic mathematician. Let's say his Spanish and Portuguese is not the only thing I can be in my team. And so he was talking of this Irish Paul O'Meara. It's Palmeira, but he pronounced it like Paul O'Meara. It sounded Irish to me, but no, it's actually Palmeira. So this is a beautiful theorem of Palmeira. And that means that if you take this foliation, take it to the universal covering, the leaf space is a one-dimensional, simply connected manifold, most probably non-Hausdorff. It's Hausdorff only if the foliation is parallel foliation. For instance, you take a torus, and you take a three-dimensional torus, and you take an irrational foliation by planes, you lift it, and it's the lifted foliation is a family of parallel planes. The quotient space in the line is identified with a transverse line. And okay, so, well, definition, I never gave a definition, but you, everybody knows that surfaces are of three types, no? And the uniformization theorem is something that tells you, given any metric, there's a unique conformal metric with curvature minus one, that's what I want, hyperbolic. And therefore, the surfaces of the type hyperbolic is with Lobachevsky metric divided by a discrete group. Therefore, that's what I'm saying. And that's the theorem again, the uniformization theorem that I was telling you. And then we prove in a paper which a president of this one has already published, we prove that for minimal foliation by hyperbolic surfaces is in here, and all these are geometrically infinite, namely the fundamental groups infinitely generated, all of them are geometrically finite. In fact, most of the times it's foliated by circles and planes. One particular case is, Carlos Simpson was speaking of Hitchin representation into PSL 2R, and or PSL 2C, or PSL 2 high dimensional type neural spaces in PSL NR, and you have these possibilities of it's always almost foliated by cylinders and planes most of the time. But anyhow, that's just one. Okay, now. One canonical way to construct three manifolds is by taking the mapping torus of a surface diffeomorphism. We in dynamical systems call that a suspension, but it's called, topologists call it the mapping torus, and therefore it's interesting. So, sigma close oriented on the surface, so genus greater or equal than one, and you take an orientation preserving homeomorphism. So if sigma has, and this gluing only depends on the diffeotopic class of the gluing map. The only thing it depends. And therefore, for the class of the torus, it only depends on the action of the fundamental group. And I assume it's the diffeomorphism orientation preserving. And therefore, you can assume with a loss of generality that is given by a matrix in SL2Z. And here, you have a trichotomy depending on the trace. Either the matrix you blue is hyperbolic, and it has two different eigenvalues, one of norm less than one, another greater than one, or it's it's like that, nilpotent, or it's periodic. So, if you suspend a homeomorphism of the torus, it's a dichotomy. Phi is periodic, phi is reducible, this is for the shell surface. Given a surface genus G, any diffeomorphism of this surface is canonically isotopic to one model. It's either periodic, is reducible. Reducible means the leaf string varies a system of curves, and therefore if you cut the surface, you decompose it into pieces, or else it's pseudo-Anosov. Pseudo-Anosov means essentially that you take any closed loop, is represented by a closed geodesic, you iterate the diffeomorphism, you take the geodesic representative, and the length of that goes to infinity. Yeah, that's one definition. Another definition is that it lives invariant pair foliations of pseudo-Anosov that were described by Carlos Simpson in his talk, like the two foliations associated to a quadratic differential, picture he drew was exactly like that. In one, it explodes, and in other, contracts. And one of the most fantastic theorems that to me, like I told you, the hero of my generation is Bill Thornton. So he proved this beautiful theorem that if you take a surface, and you take a suspension, you multiply by an interval, and you glue sigma cross zero and sigma cross one with one of these diffeomorphisms, then this three manifold is a hyperbolic manifold. Therefore, it has Riemannian metric of constant negative curvature minus one. And this theorem is so deep that the recent theorem by Ian Eagle, I mean, he was given the prize, I forgot the name of the prize, for several million dollars, but he won the prize, very well deserved, of a question by Thornton saying any hyperbolic manifold is virtually of this type. I mean, any compact hyperbolic manifold is finitely covered by one that fibers of the circle. And therefore, these pseudo-Anosov diffeomorphisms that are a generalization of Anosov. It's fantastic. I did my thesis on Anosov flows and diffeomorphisms, and I thought my thesis was in the corner of a corner. Yeah, you have this feeling, you know, you're doing your thing, the corner of a corner of a corner. But then came Thornton and he proved this theory, and then all of a sudden, I feel better, no? Like, well, perhaps we had a little bit of state. So, and it was connected with that. And so this is what it means. You can read it. This is the important one I'm using. And actually, this thesis, if you have the torus and you suspend, this trichotomy gives you either a flat torus. If you glue with identity, it's T3 with a flat matrix. If you glue with a matrix of an unipotent matrix, 1, 1, 0, n, you have a nil manifold. And if you glue with an Anosov diffeomorphism, you have a solved manifold. So these are the prototypes, the paradigm of three of the geometers, of the eight geometries of Thornton's geometrization theorem: the nil geometry, the solved geometry, and the flat geometry. And now the question arises: T3 would have a foliation by hyperbolic. And the answer is no, for several reasons. Because Gromo says that if a three manifold is foliated by hyperbolic surface, then the growth of the fundamental group of the ambient manifold is exponential. And therefore, the torus is polynomial, cannot be. But another more, actually, Sasha Efimov, another, when I met Sasha Efimov the first time, asked him, he was related to Efimov. This is a theorem by Hilbert. Suppose you have a foliation by hyperbolic surfaces in the three torus, then you take the universal covering with a flat metric, and each leaf is embedded. And there's a beautiful theorem of Hilbert that says hyperbolic plane cannot be embedded isometrically in R3. And it's generalized by Efimov, that's what I did ask you, saying if the curvature is bounded, you cannot also. And that has the implication that you cannot foliate it. But also the nil manifolds cannot foliate it, no? However, for the Anosov, yes. Because the Anosov has an action of the affine group. And the affine group is invariant matrix hyperbolic. So that if you glue with an Anosov, you have a foliation by hyperbolic surface, in the other case no. And then you have the geometry. I'm telling you repeating the result. No? If it's a suspension of a pseudo-Anosov, it's a hyperbolic manifold. It's all cases like that, no? And well, these are already. And now the geometrization of three manifolds was one of the most glorious theorems of the beginning of the 21st century, solved by Perelman, tells you that you can always cut any three-dimensional manifold along tori and spheres in such a way to have geometric models. And therefore, here I'm going to go very quickly because I realized when I finished doing my presentation that I have 103 pages. And so don't worry, you're tired, I'm not going to be 103. So I'm going to go a little fast. Okay, first the geometrization conjecture was proved by Richard Perelman. It's fantastic because he says that every three manifold can be decomposed in pieces which have one of the eight geometries. And so these two don't have foliations by hyperbolic. That one, yes, because the unit tension bundle, any manifold model on that is finally covered by the universal covering of the unit tangent bond of the surface, named SL2R Kinder. So that means that can be foliated, and but every foliation by Thorsson theorem is given by a representation of the fundamental group into that. So it's very, very beautiful. And this is a beautiful, I'm going to go quickly with that. It's a top foliation. I discovered this about 30 years ago and never published, but in this paper I decided it's, I almost forgot how it was put. So this is a three-dimensional manifold with a minimal foliation, hyperbolic foliation, with the following property. If you take the universal covering, it's R3. And the foliation, therefore, is a one-dimensional non-Hausdorff manifold. And you know what? It's a pure composé. It's non-Hausdorff everywhere. The set of poles where it's not, it's branching everywhere. It's not like this simple example, but this red phenomenon happens everywhere. And that's done the following way. I'm gonna, as you can see, this proof. And I forget, I use my hands. So you have, I'm almost Italian, but Mexican. So you have a surface of genus 2. You have a unitangent bundle, has a canonical foliation because it's SL2R divided by a subgroup, has a flat bundle. And that, here, there's a beautiful simple closed curve. Well, if you leave this foliation, it looks like the disk cross R. The universal cover, this looks like hyperbolic disk cross R. And of course, the fiber, the S1 fiber, cuts every leaf. But there are some leaves, some circle, that when you lift it, it only cuts a package. So I take this three miles, I take this closed circle, closed transversal, take out the tubular neighborhood, and take the double. And with that construction, working all that proof, long proof, you prove you have a foliation which is absolutely beautiful. You have a three-dimensional manifold that is a connected sum along tori, along one torus, with every leaf dense, and with your leaf to the universal cover, la plume composée. In la plume composée, have 1 minute for an anecdote. So one day, Georges Reb and André Heffner, both students of Eresman, were sitting in the waiting to talk to Eresman in the waiting hall, and say, "Oh, you come to talk to Monsieur Eresman?" "Yes, I do. What's your theorem?" And the anecdote, and it's a fact, was this very same theorem, that foliations of the plane are in one-to-one corresponding with cyclo-connected non-Hausdorff manifolds. Well, there's one Hausdorff with the plane. Anyhow, that's a... Well, okay, now blah, 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 blah. Well, only one point here. If a manifold is foliated by plane, then it's a theorem of Rosenberg long ago, which says that it's irreducible. But the Palmeira theorem makes that obvious, because the universal covering is R3, the manifolds automatically, by Schoeffer's theorem, automatically for free, irreducible. Because any sphere you lift it to the universal covering bounds a disk, a real, not a fake Poincaré disk, with a counterexample to the Poincaré conjecture, which doesn't exist anyhow. No, but anyhow, that's it. Okay, so like I say, okay. Well, here we do one by one the cases when this one I explained you, S3 by the Red theorem, R3 by Efimov Hilbert theorem, S2 cos 1 by Red theorem, Neil also, and this one, all these ones have, you know, S2 cross R. Well, this is easy to see one. This is the unitangent bundle of surface fluid, and H3. And so I can go one by one. Not possible. Here is a theorem by here. So Sasha, that's what I asked you. To me, you were related, because Efimov I thought was not a very...
He did not ¿Eh? No relación, no relación. But I say, hey, you know.
Anyhow, actually, there's another analyst different from that one, very famous. Well, manifolds with geometry, they cancel. Manifolds with solid geometry, yes. You see, if you suspend an anosov, it happens that is the mesh 2-1-1-1 is a paradigm. So you suspend it, and you have unstable and unstable foliations, and these are hyperbolic planes. So set one you can. But actually, parenthesis, theorem of G. Sergescu, again G. Sergescu says, you know what? These are the only two foliations with a red component in that manifold. Beautiful theorem, but that's what I met at the end the first time, and to me it's my, I have very, personal reason, I like it very much. So here, here's what I tell you, no? And you need class E2. You need class E2 because there's always a process called Danjoie. Danjoie is you take a leaf, you take a package of leaves, and you put Cantor sets. It's something like Danjoie used to do. But anyhow, manifolds with H2O, they all are given by Thorsson theory by representation of the fundamental group into this is one, etc. And actually, see, this is beautiful, the Spindler-Wood inequality. You have a circle bundle, so Thorsson says you have a circle bundle for the foliated, no red component, you can isotope to a one which is transverse. And therefore, it's given by a representation of the fundamental group into the group of different morphisms of the circle, orientation preserved. And then you say, is there any obstruction for that circle bundle? And there's a beautiful inequality by John Miller and John Wood saying that if you can do that, then the Chern class of the circle bundle, the first Chern class, has to be at most 2g minus 2. Namely, the biggest you can, the Chern class at most has to be 2g minus 2. And the theorem says that if you realize that, is actually the foliation, canonical anosov foliation. It's a beautiful theorem by many, many people. Well, let's see a little bit more. Well, forget about it. These are many things. Manifold with S2O geometry is solved once, I told you, circle bond is foliated. And this is the one I solved. We were interested in hyperbolic manifolds foliated by hyperbolic. And we do that with many constructions, but let me just go quickly a little bit. So there are cut and paste in this, but let me go fast because you are tired, you're hungry. And let me do the following. Use my hands and so you take the torus and take the matrix 2-1-1-1, for instance, and you suspend it. The matrix 2-1-1-1 gives invariant two foliations. The stable and unstable foliations. And you take the curve that goes through zero, the periodic orbital minimum. And then you take, what I'm going to do is take a branch covering, and that means that the torus is branch covered by subsurface or subgenus, and the foliation, which was actually a regular foliation by two, becomes a pseudonosal foliation. And therefore now the suspension, because of hyperbolic manifold, and you can actually construct infinitely many with this construction by just branch covering the construction. Actually, suppose you want to prove that every free manifold has a contact structure. Okay, let me give you my proof with all the mistakes that, okay. Well, you know that the sphere S3 has a contact structure. And you know that any free manifold is a branch covering of some link, smooth link over the sphere. And then a simple theorem using the Jansberg tells you that any link can be actually moved isotopically so that it becomes transverse to the distribution that gives you the contact structure. And then let me assume for a moment that these curves are actually orthogonal for some Riemannian matrix, orthogonal. And if I take the branch covering along that, you see the plane,
the playing field lifts to a playing field canonic. It's very easy to do, but you need a little calculation. But actually you can do it rigorously, what I'm saying. And therefore you lift it, and since the condition of contact is stable, because omega is still the omega, is that you get one. I never published that paper, and I said, well, there's a construction, Winkel-Kempe and Forstall, there's a construction, beautiful construction by Jasper. And here you have the problem, you don't know very much what happened, no? Anyhow, this idea is the same what I'm doing now here. So I'm taking I'm constructing manifolds, that hyperbolic manifold using branch coverings. And then to do that, well, this is the energy. You can change the topology of the leaves. For instance, you have a minimal foliation by hyperbolic surfaces. Take two closed transversals, empty the interiors of tubular neighborhoods, and glue the boundaries. It continues to be hyperbolic, it continues to be minimal, and you made a mess of the leaves. You change the topology, you can make it very rich, no? The topology. But that, so those are constructions. Well, also, suppose you have a cipher manifold with a minimal foliation. Well, then you can glue, you can get manifolds of surgery construction gives you hyperbolic foliations on graph manifolds. So graph manifolds have hyperbolic foliations, which are minimal. Hyperbolic manifolds have, you know, many. And finally, I think I like, wait, remember I have 103, so I'm going. Ah, there comes something beautiful. Okay, so you take a Pseudanosov, take a surface of genus greater than genus 2, take a Pseudanosov diffeomorphism, and take the mapping torus. That's a hyperbolic manifold. And there's a beautiful result saying that the Torelli group, it's a different Torelli, a different theorem of Torelli, say there are Pseudanosov diffeomorphisms that actually act as the identity on the homology group. You will think, people that work in hyperbolic dynamics think that a Pseudanosov has to mix all the homology like crazy. Actually, no, actually Thorson constructs directly a Pseudanosov diffeomorphism that fixes. And now, if you take the suspension, you have the one sequence. The one sequence computes the homology, and therefore you don't increase the homology. And these Torelli groups give you fantastic new foliations with different. But actually, you want to know whether you can do it, and to do that, well, I go fast in the last part of that. You use a. So this is what I'm saying. So you start here with a branch covering of the torus. Here you have a nose of diffeomorphism. It leads to a manifold that fibers of the circle. With a source of genus, high genus, and Pseudanosov, no? And, well, you put diagrams, not important, but what is important is that the construction is the one, but just go to the pictures quickly. So this is more or less the picture. So each torus leads to a branch covering with a source of genus 2. The anosov flow leads to a Pseudanosov flow, and then you said that. And the construction I want to tell you, so to justify a little bit the algebraic geometry part, we use a device of p function like the sphere with 4 points, is the pillow, no? Every conic point of order 2 is the orbifold, which parametrizes the Weierstrass function. And then you work a little bit, you use a little bit of. This is the picture, the same picture, no? And then you use also translation surfaces. You use many techniques to give the Weierstrass function. All these are just technology. Okay, but here comes the interesting thing. Technologies to prove what I'm saying can be done. That branch coverings that are foliated have minimal foliation by hyperbolic surface. Mm-hmm. But now something very beautiful happens. You see, these hyperbolic manifolds is actually a universal covering is a disk. And the minimal foliation leads to a foliation of the hyperbolic disk. And now it's a beautiful thing. For instance, take the canonical foliation by fibers. Solve the genus 2, cross an interval, glue the ends by a pseudonosal diffeomorphism. And take the obvious foliation by and that becomes a product foliation. But it's not like you think, the product of these cross R. Becomes, there's a theory, beautiful theorem that says that each of these planes extend continuously at the boundary, it's an S1, as an equivalent Peano curve. It's a beautiful theory by Cannon and Thorson. It's the Peano curve property. It's another, you see, every cell can be well ordered, right? Theory. But Thorson gives you the set of volumes of cross hyperbolic manifolds. It's a well ordered set. You know that. It's not sorry, here you have that. And also, he constructs a Peano curve geometrically together with. And that means that this foliation here, each leaf, has a continuous extension to the boundary as a Peano curve. And it's an equivariant Peano curve, so these foliations are extremely rich in dynamics. And this is what it is. And many of these things are actually, the leading set of leaves are Peano curves. And well, et cetera, et cetera. And I think with that, now you can go on it. I skip 80 pages. So that way you can. I don't get an indigestion, you don't get an indigestion, you can rest. Thank you very much for your attention.
So, questions?
Well,